Okay, so the latest measurement technique that is available is the IC stripline method. It's defined in dash 8 of this IEC 62132 standard that we have already discussed. And the very big advantage of this IC stripline technique is the higher frequency range. So we can characterize from 150 kilohertz up to 3 gigahertz, maybe 4 or 5 gigahertz. Why is this the case? We already discussed it when we were discussing the DEM cell. We said that the DEM cell is this small box about this size, and if we are decreasing the size, then we are finally ending up with a similar topology with this strip line where the septum of the DEM cell is now placed around the IC. So this is now our septum. And we have a very close distance from the IC package to this metal frame where we can force then, in this case, some RF interferences into the IC package. So for that, we also need a power amplifier and signal generator. And then we are connecting by a coaxial cable, in this case, this port here. Then we are forcing this current through the septum. So there's a current flowing here, generating a magnetic field. The magnetic field is somewhat circling around the septum. And we are also generating an electric field that is finally then ending up in a capacitive coupling from the septum to the metal traces inside the IC. And the magnetic field can also interfere with the loop areas that we have inside of the IC because the loop areas are then acting as receiving antennas. So in the end, we are also characterizing the robustness of the IC by an inductive and a capacitive coupling more or less in the same way. Well, it's not exactly in the same way, but based on these two principles. Yeah, and this terminal here is then terminated by 50 ohm. This is usually then on the side that you cannot see. Yeah, we need this standardized printed circuit board with the IC under test on one side facing then into this microstrip line. And the very big advantage is not just the frequency range, the big advantage is also the small distance, so we do not need that much input power, or in this case forward power, to generate high magnetic and electric fields within this microstrip line. Now, there is a commercially available microstrip line test fixture. In this case, this was taken from Langer EMV GmbH. It's a company in Germany, which is providing some measurement techniques for characterizing integrated circuits, for example.
Is there a special reason why these IC strip line boxes are not made like very, very small? Because then you could use it up to a higher frequency range, right? But it's not done yet, I guess.
I think it will be done in the future because, as I told you, we are trying to increase the frequency range. But the problem is also here, if you're going back a little bit. It also depends on the size of the IC package. So the problem is we have very small ICs with small packages. So there we can shrink this microstrip line down to very small geometries and then further increase the frequency range. But think of a big microprocessor or an FPGA. That should also be characterized, then you might probably end up with a structure that more or less looks like this, and then it's limited anyway. And this thing was constructed in order to characterize big ICs and also small ICs. But maybe in the future we will come up with different sizes of the IC strip line, and the one goes then to 3 gigahertz and the other one goes then to 8 gigahertz for smaller ICs. Or maybe you come up with a even better idea, because this mechanical construction here is also not very super high frequency. Especially here, the terminations and especially how it's designed, it's matching somehow as good as possible 50 ohm, but it's definitely not exactly 50 ohm. So maybe you can come up with further ideas how to improve this termination and how the SMA connector is soldered to the this metal septum, whatever it's called. But up to 3 gigahertz, I think it's fine. Okay.